This is my first dual motor electric scooter. I have it for about 3 years or 4 already. And back then when I got it, it had a name. Kugo G Booster or Honghao S12. Now I can't call it like that. And you guys told me that I can't name it Kugo G Booster anymore because it's not a Kugo G Booster anymore. And Petty gave me this idea to name it the Dre Mobile. So this is now the Dre Mobile. It doesn't have the stickers now because it's not 100% done. But I'm showing you in the last part of the upgrade, which is this one, which controllers I used and how were they mounted on the scooter. And after that, we'll take a closer look and fire it up to see how it works. Alright, let's see some lights. That's it for now. I'm missing the lights for the plexi cover. And yeah, I didn't plan for this box to be here, but as you've seen, the controllers are pretty thick and the aluminum cooling system is also about this thick, so there's no space in here for anything else. So I have in here the step down and the A-wheel module for the controllers so that I can connect the brake light and the acceleration and such. I got the U-Box 100 amps controllers, which are already way too much for what I'm building because the battery is not gonna drain like 200 amps. So I'm using half of the power of the controllers, but I'm also using a high voltage. I'm using 72 volts, so these controllers can take up to 100 volts. So I made my choice. These are the controllers. They work pretty good. You have a link in the description if you want to check the specs. And I won't say anything more for now because I'm working on a video of the full process and you'll get all the details in there. check this out. So this is the actual power button. Press it once, it makes some beeping, and I wait for it to power up. It's like a Windows, it takes some time. Then the LED powers green and the scooter is good to go. Fair warning, the motors are kinda squeaky because I didn't lubricate the seals on them. The seals are like this big and I need some really thin and penetrating oil to lubricate them. So for now we are gonna listen to the motors besides the squeaking. Hear them out. Yeah. So the speed now was above 100 kilometers per hour. This is the app. I can connect to the controllers. I can also connect the controllers through a USB-C cable directly to my laptop. But this is the quick setting up. You can set the parameters in here and make the scooter work. Now let's check on the RT data and I'm gonna start the scooter, but not too fast because the tires get really slim when they go too fast and they tend to touch the suspension. So I'm only getting like this fast. This is enough. I can go over it easily, but it's gonna smell like burnt tires. So as you can see, I can start really slow. That's nice. Okay, and if I want to just go, and this also applies on the street, it goes like there's no stop, there's nothing stopping the power from getting to the motors. It's just like the controllers are not there and the motors are directly connected to the battery.
Hai că mai dau o tură. Bă, cât de frumos poate să meargă. Unge pe suflet.